Malacañang mum on how the reunion between President Duterte and Senator Manny Pacquiao would impact the lawmaker's 2022 presidential bid. The two leaders met on Wednesday, months after a rift developed from Pacquiao's allegations of corruption within the Duterte administration. The palace calls the meeting a renewal of friendship.
Ang alam ko lang po, nagkaroon ng renewal ng pagkakaibigan ng Presidente at saka si Senator Manny Pacquiao. Hindi ko po alam kung anong magiging epekto nitong bagong pagkakaibigan sa kandidatura ni Senator Manny Pacquiao.
Pacquiao clarifies his meeting with Duterte is not political, but he said they did talk about their shared vision for Mindanao. Pacquiao also maintains he isn't backing out from the presidential race. Duterte and Pacquiao belong to feuding factions in the ruling PDP Laban Party. Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio now in Balisin Island following a rumored meeting with former Philippine President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. The president's daughter will reportedly attend the birthday party of House Speaker Lord Alan Velasco. There are speculations Duterte Carpio will meet with Arroyo to join her party, Lakas CMD, paving the way for the Davao City Mayor to be a substitute candidate for a national post after she dropped her re-election bid. But Arroyo's camp has denied the reports. Lakas CMD previously expressed openness for possible substitutions for their standard bearers. Duterte Carpio, meanwhile, is credited for Arroyo's speakership in 2018. The camp of presidential aspirant Ferdinand Marcos Jr. says it will respect Duterte Carpio's plans for 2022, whatever they may be. It adds the Partido Federal ng Pilipinas will welcome Duterte Carpio as the running mate of Marcos if she decides to gun for a national post.
Hindi ba nung nagpulong sila sa Cebu City nung yung kanilang pagkikita ng kasama at sa opisina ni Governor Gwen Garcia, gobernador ng Cebu City, ay sa pag-uusap na yon ay sinabi nga ng ating mayora ng Davao City na wala siyang balak ng tumakbo bilang pangulo. Ano po? At kami naman po, kung ano naman ang magiging desisyon ng ating Pangulo. Pangulo, ibig sabihin, si Senator DBM yun. Aming pagpupulong ng hanay ng Partido Federal ng Pilipinas sa San Cotabato, irerespetuhin namin yun.
The Philippine Elections Commission says Duterte Carpio will need to join a national party to substitute for a national post. Under election rules, Duterte Carpio will need to be a party mate of the candidate she is substituting for.
Well, if she's intending to run for a national office, she can do so as a member of her regional party, but she would be running for that national office as an independent. However, if she becomes a member of a political party, then she can, in theory, substitute for whatever political party's candidate has already filed for that national office. You have to be carried by a national party. That means you have to receive a certificate of nomination and acceptance, a CONA, from that political party. And if you accept a CONA from a political party, then it's a practically sure bet that you're a part of that political party.
Jimenez adds the COMELEC has no timetable yet for its decision on the disqualification petition against presidential bet Ferdinand Marcos Jr.
As far as the administrative process goes, it probably takes about 2 to 3 weeks. But the decision, how long the decision will take to come out, there is no timetable for that. When we talk about the cancellation, that one is likely to be resolved before the election. But when you talk about a disqualification case, remember that a disqualification case can be filed at any time, even just before proclamation, right? Mm-hmm. So a disqualification case might be a different, will be a different story altogether. But as far as cancellation, again, while in theory it can take as long as it takes, in practice it usually gets resolved fairly quickly.